Today I'm going to discuss post-stroke constipation and erectile sensation. And this is a very interesting topic. And well, it's more basic knowledge that we will get from it and maybe some really interesting ideas for future research and options for pelvic physiotherapy. So welcome back to Pelvic News Channel, the channel for all physiotherapists with an interest in the pelvic region and who want to learn about the latest scientific research. Well, if you like this channel, please hit the notification bell down below or subscribe to this channel. Constipation is very common among post-stroke patients. And although it influences the quality of life negatively, there's often not a lot of attention for it. And it is known that the colon transit time takes longer in post-stroke patients with constipation, but we don't know if the anal rectal manometry or the rectal sensation has been influenced as well. So today's research I'm going to discuss has a look if the rectal sensation and the anal rectal motility has changed in post-stroke patients with constipation. And it looks if the stroke site has an impact on the constipation, and it will look at if there are any independent risk factors for post-stroke constipation. For this study, stroke patients were included and age and sex matched healthy controls. The exclusion criteria were constipation before the stroke, intestinal diseases in the past, abdominal operators other than appendectomy or colostomy, and organic diseases like a spinal cord injury, a traumatic brain injury, or a thyroidal dysfunction, and pregnant and lactating women. And the definition of constipation was based on two criteria. The patients had to have at least two of the symptoms in at least 25% of the defecations. And the symptoms were straining, lumpy or hard stool, a sensation of incomplete evacuation, sensation of anal rectal obstruction or blockage, and a manual help to empty the bowel, and less than 3 spontaneous bowel movements per week. And the second criteria was loose stools, hardly ever spontaneous. The patients had to fill in a 1 week bowel diary with, for instance, the time spent on the toilet, the Bristol stool scale, the use of laxatives, digital maneuvers, spontaneous bowel movements. They also had to fill in the sensation of incomplete emptying after defecation or after successful defecation if it was with straining. And for the anal rectal manometry, the patient was inside lying with the hips and the knees bent, and it was laying on the left side. And the manometry was measuring the resting pressure during straining and during squeezing. And the other tests that were done was the rectal sensation and the anal inhibitory reflex. And the patients also had to fill in 2 questionnaires, one on the quality of life on constipation and one on the symptoms of constipation. In total, 71 patients were included, 34 patients with constipation and 37 patients without constipation. And the average time post-stroke was about 9 days, so roughly 75% of these patients were still in the acute phase. And the men and the women were equally divided. And patients with post-stroke constipation had significantly less physical activity. They drank less, so there was less fluid intake. They used more antihypertension medication. They used more laxatives and suppositories. They had less spontaneous bowel movements and a firmer Bristol stool form, and they spend more time on the toilet. And the symptom score and the quality of life score, they were higher in the constipated patients as well. And if we have a look at the anal rectal manometry, this research found that the first sensation, the first desire, and the urge to defecate in the constipated patients was significantly later than in the non-constipated patients and in the healthy controls. And there was no difference between the non-constipated patients and the healthy controls. And the impaired rectal sensation was weakly to moderately correlated with constipation. And if we have a look at the anal rectal manometry, there was no significant difference between the groups for the anal resting pressure, the maximum squeeze pressure, and the duration of the contraction. And the increase in rectal pressure during straining was significantly less for the constipated patient. And there was no paradoxical contraction in any of the groups, so not in the constipated, the non-constipated, and in the healthy controls. And this research also found that the patients with brainstem lesions had significantly more constipation than the patients with different types of stroke. And the patients with the brainstem lesion also had higher thresholds for the first sensation compared to the non-brainstem lesions. And the independent risk factors they found for the post-stroke constipation was the higher threshold for a desire to defecate and less physical activity. This is really interesting research showing that the rectal sensation is compromised in post-stroke patients with constipation. It also showed that the patients with brainstem lesions are more at risk of developing constipation. And there was, this might be due to, neural damage. And there was no sign of paradoxical contraction in any of the groups. And they also found that the patients who are inactive are more at risk of developing constipation. Well, this is not new for us, because that's a risk factor for a lot of patients. And this was the first study on this topic, so more research is definitely needed. And in this study, 75% of the patients were in the acute phase. So I hope in future studies that they will follow these patients over time, so more prospective cohort studies. And I would also like to see more differentiation between the types of stroke. This research also had a fourth research question on the exploration of autonomic functions. And if you're interested in that topic, well, I invite you to read the full text article. And what might be interesting for the pelvic physiotherapist in the future is some research that's done on transcutaneous electrical acoustimulation, which is which is a kind of electrical stimulation with surface electrodes placed on acupuncture points. And they're doing research on the improvement on the rectal sensations, and well, the first outcomes, they're quite promising. And if I learn about new research, of course, I'll keep you up to date with that. And well, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And see you next time. Bye bye.